Come on, what's this for?
You need to get one.
You starting a gang? Sharks and the Jets, or the Bloods and the Crips? Obviously, when I say Crips, I wasn't...
You're not safe without a hat. Look around. The hair, Sheldon. Look at the hair. Bobby's in. Hairdresser's shooting. Gives you a free haircut, but he decides what you get.
Oh, I love what you've done to the back.
Is that all right? Yeah. I've just brought it out.
He's all over him. Look, it's disgusting.
Why do you care?
I don't.
You've had your hair cut, haven't you?
No.
Yes, you have. Ooh, haircut, haircut.
Shut it.
He's not done a bad job there.
He didn't do it.
You went out to get your hair cut. You didn't pay for it, did you? How much?
20 quid.
20 quid? Are you on the pull or something?
No, I just wanted to look nice.
I get it. You are on the pull.
I'm not.
Go on, don't hide, Paul. You're sex on wheels with that haircut.
Sheldon!
All you need now is a personality to go with it. Sid, what's happened? Someone stick your finger in a light socket.
I've been attacked. It's the same one. I thought she'd gone, but she's back.
She?
Yeah, I was crossing the road earlier on and I felt a tap on my shoulder. I turned round, it was there, going at me.
Are you okay? Did you see her face?
Tell him who it was.
It was a goose.
A what?
A goose.
A goose?
A goose. A bloody great big one and vicious as well. Going at me, it was flapping its wings, there was feathers everywhere. It was hissing and it was spitting.
Slow down, Sid, you're gabbling.
Piss off.
You were attacked by a goose?
No feathers on you, though, are there? No beak marks.
And you'd know what beak marks look like, would you?
Oh, yes. Oh,
lay off him, Paul. Have you reported it, Sid? You should call someone.
Who am I going to call?
Goosebusters.
Sheldon, come with me, please. Now, it's urgent.
Oh, sales sign.
Yeah, quick, before anyone else sees it.
Oh, thanks, Steve, but I don't think I could afford the place.
A bit too big for my needs, besides, I need a place in the garage.
Oh, don't be stupid, get rid of it.
All right.
There's been some sort of mistake. Bramble Lodge is not for sale. It's just, I can't get rid of it myself. Oh, oh.
Well, give me a ring. I'll just come and take it down.
No, I want it getting rid of now.
I'll get me stuff.
I said now, Sheldon.
Oh, all right, all right.
Damage. Hello, Jean. Just keeping up to date on his latest felonies.
He's doing a favour for me, actually.
Yeah, if you say so, Jean. Can I have a word, please? Basically, you'd report it to me, and then I could investigate without raising too much suspicion.
Thank you, Sergeant. But I do think it's unlikely that any of our residents are creating Al-Qaeda sleeper cells.
So do I, Jean. It's 1,000 to 1. But, I mean, if you need me.
Right. I'm actually quite busy.
So. Oh, sorry, I'm. Get out your way.
Right.
Oh! While I'm here, I thought you might be able to use this.
Oh. A spa voucher?
Yeah. I won it in the station raffle. I thought it was for spa, you know, the shops, but it turns out it's massage, tanning. All that kind of stuff. It's not really my cup of tea, so I thought, if anyone needs that, that's you.
Oh, thank you. Are you saying I'm in need of beautification, Sergeant?
No, Jean. I'm just saying, you know, if anyone deserves a rest, a bit of pampering, rub down. Anyway, it's booked for this afternoon.
And there's no one else you'd rather give it to? A girlfriend? No special lady?
No. No special lady.
It's great, that paw. Makes you look like Tom Cruise.
I know. Feeling at the back there.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Lovely.
Don't stop.
Officer, I'd like to report an assault.
Right, can you describe him?
She was white, bluey-green eyes, about 3 foot tall, webbed feet.
Leave it, Sarah. We've had all this before. Come on, we've got real criminals to catch.
Or have we?
I mean, in general.
Jean, you've seen that goose, haven't you?
Have I, Eric?
Oh, you must have on those cameras. It's a cover-up.
Don't be silly. We don't cover things up at Bramble Lodge.
Where do you want this for sale sign, Jean?
Oh, you mean the firewood?
I mean this for sale sign.
It's a bit weird. Suspicious is what I call it. As soon as I challenged her about that goose, she was off.
Gotcha.
You knob, I've just had that cut.
Who by? Stevie Wonder?
A barber.
A barbarian, more like. You'd probably sue for that.
I could sue you for ruining it.
Oh, you're right. I'm sorry. Let's have a look, see if I can fix it. Got you twice. Bye.
Bobby!
Bye, Bobby. It's a good laugh, isn't it?
Who cut your hair? Stevie Wonder?
Not funny.
I know. That's what he just said to me.
Did he?
Oh, and it's clever now he's said it. You do know he's gay.
He's just friendly. You should try it sometime.
Sorry, you two. Don't want to interrupt anything. Here, should you, Paul and Dorothy, they're bickering like an old married couple.
Yeah.
Oh, so obvious they fancy each other. Be the perfect couple, wouldn't it? Same age, same background, same height. We should get it together.
You know, you're right, Shell. Only problem is, they're both too shy. I mean, you know how they pretend not to like each other, you know.
You leave that to me. I set them up on a secret date. Love is blind, but the warden ain't.
What are you up to?
Playing Cupid, Graham. You know, Paul and Dorothy.
They can't stand each other.
Yeah, I know. Good, isn't it?
Moss Lane Police Station, PC Madden speaking. Hello?
Hello, is there anybody there?
Hello? Oh, is there a problem? Are you having trouble, miss?
I...
Who are you talking to?
No one. I answered and there was no one there.
Oh, must be a secret admirer.
What secret admirer? Have I got a secret admirer? Who is it?
Well, it wouldn't be a secret then, would it?
Why do you think she fancies me?
Beats me. Must be the hair.
Yeah, she did say she liked it.
So shall I sort out a date for you?
You know I don't need you sorting out my love life for me, Sheldon.
I know.
I'm getting plenty already.
Of course you are.
I just don't feel the need to go around talking about it.
I know that, Paul, but... On the off chance you can squeeze any more sex into your already busy life, what shall I tell her?
Tell her yes.
Hey, Dorothy.
So are you seeing anyone at the moment?
Oh, Sheldon, I'm really flattered, but...
Oh, no, not me. Oh, yeah. I think you're a Bobby Dazzler.
Right. Who?
That'd be telling, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would. So tell me.
Well, let's just say he's an eligible young man. Attractive. Fairly. Clever. Sort of. Funny. Ish. And he's free tonight.
So he definitely likes me?
Oh, definitely. You don't go to that much trouble over a haircut unless you really like someone.
I suppose not. Oh, thank you, Sheldon. Tell him yes, I'd love to. Oh. I told Paul he wasn't gay.
Did you?
Didn't believe me, but I can prove it now, can't I?
Yeah, you prove it to him. He'd enjoy that. Hey, Polly. Looking suave.
I'll have to cancel.
Hey? It's all been arranged now. She's gagging for it. Come on, don't get all nervous on me now.
I'm not nervous. I've got loads of girlfriends.
Of course you have, but I thought tonight was a rare window in your busy... sexual schedule.
I'm skint. I can't afford to take her anywhere.
Well, have it here then. Have it on the table. And then have some food afterwards.
Yeah. And anyway, I can't cook.
Oh, bloody hell, Paul. You're not making this very easy.
It's all right for you. You're a tramp. You've got nothing to live up to. You'd stick a candle in a hobnailed boot and open a tin of sardines. Women expect more from a man like me.
So give her more then. Give her something more exotic. Hey, what about Sid?
He's not exotic.
I'm not suggesting a threesome, Paul. You told me he does amazing curries.
He does. What he doesn't do is favours for me.
I'll worry about that. You just concentrate on which one of those shirts you want ripping off you later on.
I mean, you believe me, don't you, Graham?
No.
Oh, come on. It's not like I've been abducted by aliens. It were a goose. There's millions of geese in the world.
You're a weirdo.
Gentlemen.
Set. Tonight, Paul's flat, 8 o'clock.
Ah, well done, Scylla.
There is, there is just one thing I might need your help with.
What?
I've heard it rumoured that you do an amazing curry.
Well, you've heard right. But I don't do them for now.
But what about if I supplied the ingredients? How do you fancy a nice goose, Spooner?
What?
Yeah, me and you, outside. You as bait, me crouched in the bushes, with me knife.
Won't work.
Why not?
There is no goose.
There bloody is a goose.
Yeah, and we're gonna prove it. I'm the man. Come on, Sid. Let's take that bitch out.
Gene, have you got any candles?
What do you want candles for?
In case there's a power cut.
No, I haven't.
What about flowers?
What do you want flowers for?
Don't.
Oh, Paul, I haven't got time for messing around today. I'm going for a beauty treatment.
Oh, surely not. You're beautiful enough already.
Oh, Paul, you're silver-tongued so-and-so. Bet you know how to charm a lady, don't you? Oh, it'll be lovely. I'm having bronzing, facial, and what's the other one?
Brazilian?
Aromatherapy. You ought to try it, you know. They make you look $1 million.
Oh, really look $1 million? Look at this hair.
Is that a bobby?
No, it's my own. I paid for this.
Oh, I can't wait. In 3 hours' time, I shall look irresistible.
I don't think this is going to work, mate.
You're supposed to be bait. Just do a quack or something.
Quack.
You have to do better than that.
Quack.
Flap your arms or something. Have a bit of patience. It's like a military manoeuvre.
Whack. Fight a lot of poultry in the army, did you, soldier boy?
Look, I'm on your side here. Everyone in there thinks this goose is a red herring.
She's real, but she's clever.
Yeah, it's like she's worked it out. Like she knows you're not on your own.
Exactly. We should give up.
Yeah. You're right, Sid. Time to give up. I'm going to go back inside and leave you sitting there all on your own. Going in now.
Back.
Gene, what do you think of this top? Oh, who are you trying to impress?
I've impressed him already. Bobby sort of asked me out.
Bobby? I thought he was...
He's just outgoing.
Where's he taking you?
All will be revealed.
It will be if you buy that top.
Jean!
Paul, I thought you were her then.
There is no her. Captain Beaky made it up.
Listen, do you hear that? That sounds like a distant flap.
And what if I tell you that this same goose has been after him for 6 years? 6 years! They only live for 3, I looked it up.
30. They live up to 30 years.
Sheldon, please tell me this wasn't the plan to get me my curry for tonight.
Well, you know, 2 birds with 1 stone.
Thanks, Sheldon. What will make do with chicken copper soup?
No chance. Your curry will be delivered on time. And if it's over half an hour late, you get a free bottle of fizzy pop. Hey, Sid, where are you going? You got work to do. Hey.
Oh, Paul. I have got some candles after all. I've left them on my desk for you.
Oh, Tar. Are they scented? Only Sheldon's been living there a while and the window's jammed.
Oh, I bet that really gets on your wick. You know who I think likes me? That Paul at Bramble Lodge.
People often get crushed on an authority figure. You'll have noticed that with me and Jean.
That's because she's an authority figure.
Not a me.
Oh. No, not noticed.
Oh, well, that's because I've had to put her off, obviously. You know, you can't let a relationship develop. You don't know where it might lead. You could end up...
happy?
No, you don't, don't fancy this lad, do you? Mm-hmm. But he's a...
he's a what?
You know, he's in a... he uses a...
wheelchair?
Well, he does.
So what?
So why would you want to go out with him? You're already allowed down the front at football matches.
I don't even know why I told you.
No. Fair play, Sarah. Good for you. Well done.
Well done for what?
Hey, I'll have to watch you now, hey? You'll have us down that lodge all the time, won't you, hey? Any excuse. We can go down now if you want.
Fire up the stove, Sydney.
What's that?
I'll tell you where it is. Dinner is served.
Is that?
Yeah, the great white goose.
You bought that from a shop?
Yeah, of course I did, Sid. Geese are us. There's a Blue Cross sale on.
Well, I suppose it could be, eh? How did you catch it?
Old Gurkha technique. Best you don't know the details.
You two in the common room now. A crime has been committed.
As you all know, I am not a stickler for security. I leave my office door open because I trust you. But today that trust has been abused. And we don't abuse trust at Bramble Lodge. Somebody stole a voucher from my office. Could very easily make a phone call and find out who used that voucher, but I'm not going to do that. Because I want them to do the right thing and own up. So, has anybody got anything they'd like to say? Yes, Paul.
Have you looked down the back of your desk? Might have fallen down there.
Thank you, Paul. No, it's not there. Anything else? Right. In that case, I shall have to conduct my own investigation. Thank you for your time.
Ball, you should be ashamed of yourself, huh? Stealing from Jean, she's not on.
Don't know what you're talking about.
Please, let me touch that lovely golden skin.
Get off! She's caught the sun, that's all.
Yeah, you're not the only one who's caught something.
Mm-hmm. You are joking.
No, I'm not. Hope you're hungry.
You didn't think you'd get away with it.
Okay, I know. I shouldn't have done it. Heat of the moment.
I didn't think they'd spray it on so thick.
Pathetic.
It was a crime of passion.
Done to impress a certain woman police constable.
By blacking up.
You're clever, but I've got a blind date with her tonight.
In your sordid dreams, Paul. It's not a blind date if you know who it's with.
Jealousy doesn't suit you, Dorothy. No, wait. It does.
I'm not jealous, though, am I? Because I've got a blind date, too, with Bobby.
It's not a blind date if you know who it's with.
Sheldon made it pretty obvious.
Sheldon set it up.
Shit.
What do you reckon, Graham?
More coriander.
You're the boss.
It's a really lovely warm feeling, doesn't it, getting two people together? Hey, we should start a dating agency.
Do you know anybody would think it were you going on this date?
Well, you never know. They might get married. Hey, you could do the buffet.
Hey, I tell you what, this'll feed more than two people, shall?
Do you reckon?
Yeah, do you, greedy bugger. Feed a football team with that.
Well, I'll tell you what, then. You throw on a couple of modgy patties and we'll have a dinner party. You tell the residents and I'll get the OK from Jean.
Good idea.
Hey, I'll get me Michael Ball tape. Yes!
Jean?
Paul?
Jean?
Anything you'd like to tell me?
Can't think of anything in particular.
It's just you're a bit of a strange colour, that's all.
Am I?
Oh, Paul. That That voucher was worth £50. I was looking forward to pampering myself. Just for once.
Why are you telling me?
Because you stole it. I gave you plenty of time to own up, but you haven't.
I didn't steal it.
Here.
Oh, Graham, what's the matter?
I don't feel very well.
Oh, you look awful.
Oh, Jean, I feel ill too. I think that's why I look flushed. There must be a virus going round.
You don't look ill. You look tanned.
I am. Look, my hair's falling out.
Oh, right. Well, if you're not well, you'll have to go to bed then, won't you? And you'll have to miss Sid's curry party.
I don't care. I want to go to bed.
Fine. Let's see what the doctor says, shall we?
What's going on, Paul?
I'm ill. I'm at death's door.
You will be in a minute. I murdered a goose for you.
Could have done that anyway, you bloodthirsty psycho.
Get up a bed.
No!
Yes, your curry's made and your date's been settled.
Yeah, my blind date with Dorothy.
Ah. You know.
Thanks a million for that one, Shell. Why did you think I was her secret admirer?
I've seen you watching her.
You've seen me watching Pingu. Doesn't mean I want to shag it.
Yeah, but you've got so much in common.
Like what?
Well, you're both...
disabled. That's it. That's all you needed.
I'm sorry. It was a mistake. You still come and eat with us, though, can't you?
Can't. Highly contagious. Can't be in contact with anyone. Especially Dorothy.
Sod you, then.
Sheldon.
What?
Could get Sid to bring me a plate of curry?
Yeah.
Large.
All right.
Some pilau rice.
All right.
Some poppadoms.
All right.
And mango chutney.
All right!
Hello. Oof. Wow.
Wow what?
Well, I just came by to see how you got on at the spa.
There's a story attached to that.
But I hardly need to ask. You look fantastic.
No, I didn't actually get that far.
Really beautiful. Healthy, I mean. Were you glowing?
Am I?
You look radiant, Jean. You feel better for it?
Yes. Yeah, I suppose I do. Paul! What the hell gave you the idea I like Paul?
Well, I just thought you kept it hidden.
Oh, leave me alone.
Oh, Dorothy, it's a simple mistake. Oh, come and have some booner.
Do one.
Poppadom.
Up yours.
None.
Is Paul about?
Oh, yeah, he's in bed. He's got the lurgy.
Oh, bless. I might just nip in, you know, mop his brow for him, plump his pillars.
I wouldn't, love. He might be contagious. He'll end up as grouchy as he is.
Fair enough. Well, I'd better wait for the boss anyway.
Why, what's happened? Won another prize at the station raffle, has he?
What station raffle?
Sarah!
Oh. Hiya. Is Dorothy about?
Why?
Come to finish her off.
Oh.
A hair, silly. What, you like you?
I wouldn't go near her. She's in a filthy mood.
Oh, that's how I like him.
No, seriously, mate, I'd leave it. What?
You ever thought of using some product in that?
Ladies and gentlemen, your goose is cooked.
Ta-da! Look at that.
Woo! Thanks for inviting me.
Oh, you're all right, mate. Thanks for the dandy hairstyle.
Here's the party. Room for a couple more, isn't there?
I want a word with you. Some reports of a man abducting geese in a local park. For some reason, I thought of you.
Don't know anything about that. Chicken booner?
Well, I'd have a bit, yeah.
Most of the residents, you know, and this is Bobby. He's a friend of Dorothy's.
I'm just outgoing.
Get hold of yourself. You're in uniform.
I can't believe Paul's not here.
Yeah, well, I dropped a bowl in for him earlier.
I did all this for his benefit. That's the last time I slay a goose for a friend.
Yeah, well, you tried your best, Shell. Just enjoy it.
Everyone, stop what you are doing.
Graham, what are you doing here?
Yeah, Graham, you're contagious. Bug off.
What did the doctor say?
Food poisoning.
From what?
Sid's curry.
What?
I'll tell Paul. 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 Paul.
Go on. Say it.
There isn't a button for it.
For God's sake, Graham, please don't tell anyone.
How long?
None of your business.
He means how long... Strictly a one-night stand. And please believe me, it does not repeat not being that we like each other.
Don't breathe a word.
I have to start locking that door.
That hair does make you look good.
Thanks. Your tan makes you look less like you.
Cheers.
I wonder what Graham came in for anyway.
Dunno.
Fancy a bit more curry?
Yeah, go on.
Well, congratulations, Sid. You've succeeded in poisoning everyone.
You lot can't take real curries, that's your problem.
I've eaten out of bins for years and never felt this sick.
I don't blame me. You provided the ingredients.
Well, don't thank me for getting that goose off your back.
Sheldon?
Paul, I'm sorry about this Dorothy thing. It's just ridiculous. I mean, what was I thinking?
Have you talked to anyone?
I mean, you two in bed together, as if.
Graham hasn't said anything.
No, he's as sick as everyone else.
It's ironic, really, in a way. Sid's goose got everyone apart from Sid. Is the only one not sick?
Hang on. You didn't actually believe it was Sid's goose, did you?
Wasn't it?
Sid's goose doesn't exist. I got that one from down the park.
Oh.
Still, served its purpose. Won't have him going on about goose attacks anymore, will we? Well, should we call it a night? If it's any darker, I won't be able to see with that tan.
Shut it.
Who said that? Hello? Paul?
Get
hello?
Lost. Get off!
Hello? So who did you think I'd set you up with?
No one.
Oh, not Jean?
No.
You and Jean. Ha ha, never a guess.
I do not fancy Jean.
Hey, she's not that bad looking. I wouldn't climb over her to get to you.
Good. Probably crush her.
Oh, not you again.
You're going to end up taking my job, you are.
We're just making Bramble Lodge part of the wider community.
Oh, good idea, you know, with all this talk of closure.
There is no talk of closure.
So when is this place closing?
For you two, right now.